Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the incomplete case of Aruna Shenbog written by Peter Ronald D'Souza. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very, very important for your essay and interview preparation. Now in order to properly understand this editorial, we must be very clear about the concept of euthanasia, and we must also be very clear about what are the recommendations of the court of the judiciary with respect to euthanasia. Now let us start with what is euthanasia. Now euthanasia is an attempt to end the life which is undergoing a lot of suffering, which is undergoing a lot of grief, which is undergoing a lot of pain, which is undergoing lot and lot of trauma. So euthanasia is ending of the life. Now if we look euthanasia with respect to the Indian circumstances, we need to judge it from the compatibility of the Indian constitution. Now as far as Indian constitution is concerned, there is article 21. This article is about right to life. Now as far as all the articles of the constitution are concerned, along with the positive connotation, they also have a negative connotation attached with them. Now what is the negative connotation of the fundamental rights? Now like we have the right to freedom of speech and expression, this right also confers on us the right to remain mute, to be expressless, not to express ourselves. Similarly, it was in the beginning, it was thought that the right to life, it also confers on the people the right to die also, the negative right. But that is not the case. It has been upheld by the court that the right to life means only right to life. It don't mean the right to die. Now then, what is all about euthanasia? How to make, how to end the sufferings of the people who are lying in a vegetative state, a state of coma, where they are not in a state of awareness, where they cannot perform their regular life functions. In such a case, what should be done with them? Now, this has been decided by the judiciary in the case of Aruna Shenbog. But before we understand that, we need to understand about the various types of euthanasia. Now as far as euthanasia is concerned, we can broadly divide this euthanasia into three types. We have a voluntary euthanasia, we have non-voluntary euthanasia, then we have got involuntary euthanasia. Non-voluntary euthanasia, involuntary euthanasia and voluntary euthanasia. Now voluntary ka kya meaning hota hai? What is meant by voluntary? It means apne aap. Now voluntary euthanasia is a kind of a euthanasia which you can compare it with committing suicide. In when a patient, when a person who is undergoing grief and trauma, he wants himself of his own to end his life, that kind of a euthanasia is known as voluntary euthanasia. Then another type is non-voluntary euthanasia, where a person is not capable enough to give his consent for administering something which may cause his death. That kind of a euthanasia is known as non-voluntary euthanasia. Now non-voluntary euthanasia, it is further divided into two types. The active euthanasia, active non-voluntary euthanasia and passive non-voluntary euthanasia. Now what is active? Now, euthanasia itself means ending of the life. When we deliberately administer such a kind of a drug which may lead to the malfunctioning or the dysfunctioning of the vital organs of the body, that will be known as active non-voluntary euthanasia. आपने जानबूझ के कुछ इस तरह का सब्सटेंस एडमिनिस्टर कर दिया है बॉडी में कि उस आदमी की डेथ हो जाएगी. इट इज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक पॉइजनिंग ऑफ द बॉडी. नाउ एज फार एज द एक्टिव नॉन वॉलंटरी यूथेनेशिया इज कंसर्न्ड, दिस इज नॉट परमिसेबल इन एनी कंट्री ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. इट इज अ इलीगल थिंग. नाउ another type is passive non-voluntary euthanasia. How can we differentiate between active and passive? Passive just means you withdraw the life support system. When you will withdraw the life support system, when you will not provide with a therapeutic cure, that will actually lead to the death of the person. And that kind of euthanasia is known as passive euthanasia. You are not deliberately making an effort to end the life of that person, but you are not making an effort to save his life. आप उसको बचाने की कोशिश नहीं कर रहे हो. तो उस तरह का euthanasia को passive euthanasia बोला जाता है. And the third type is involuntary euthanasia. Involuntary euthanasia is completely illegal. When a person who himself wants to live, who can give his consent, and who is giving a consent that he or she wants to live, but by the external forces, somebody from the outer world is forcing that person to die, that kind of euthanasia is known as involuntary euthanasia. Now, this is actually incompatible with the Article 21 of the Constitution. Voluntary euthanasia, you can compare it with section 309 of IPC, that is committing suicide. And as far as the active and the passive euthanasia is concerned, in India, only the passive euthanasia is legalized. And this is also pending with the constitutional bench of the Supreme Court. Till now, the legal condition is that, the legal status of the euthanasia is that the passive euthanasia is allowed in India. And there are recommendations of the Supreme Court of how we can go about this passive euthanasia. Like suppose, I am not able to perform my regular life functions, I am in a vegetative state. In that condition, my near or dear ones, my relatives, my family members, they will go to a high court that the passive euthanasia should be administered to me. In that case, the high court will appoint two judges, and those two judges will appoint or take the recommendations of the three doctors. Now, those doctors will decide about whether my brain is dead or I am in a vegetative state. Now, as per that, a notice will again be sent to my relatives who would have referred the case to the High Court that this is the recommendation of the doctors. Now, if the doctors will say that I am lying in a vegetative state, in that case, the life support system will be withdrawn and I will be forced towards the destiny, the ultimate destiny, that is the death. So, this is the entire thing about euthanasia. Now, from mains examination point of view, this is sufficient to you, but you, in order to properly analyze it from the examination point of view, you must compare it with section 309, the suicide thing, and these three type of euthanasias. And you must also know about the entire case, Pinky Virani and Arma Shanbog case, how she had fought for ending the life of Aruna Shanbog. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. You can also visit our websites to avail the information on the classes that we are offering. and the name of the website is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you liked this video, please do click on the like button, do share this video and do comment on this video. And the question for the day is, critically analyze the concept of euthanasia. So this is all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.